Well, the BAFTAs are underway right now in London, where Hollywood royalty is rubbing shoulders with actual royalty. Prince William and Kate Middleton are at the awards, but just how close will the Tinseltown stars get to the royal couple? Well, we are joined from London by our royal correspondent, Neil Shaun. Very good morning to you, Neil.
Morning.
Now, lots of excitement for Kate and Wills at the BAFTAs. What is the Duchess wearing? The very important question, of course.
Oh, the most important question, because it's a freezing night here in London, a very, very cold night. It's at the Royal Albert Hall, of course, just down the road from where they live in Kensington Palace. And Kate arrived looking, I think, possibly the most beautiful she's looked to date, girls, let me tell you. She's wearing this lovely... honestly, gorgeous. And it's so cold, I can't begin to tell you. But she's got this lovely off-the-shoulder number on by Alexandra McQueen, a very favourite designer of hers, of course. And she just looked absolutely stunning. Of course, poor Prince William, the Duke of Cambridge, of course, you know, you're in a dinner suit, you can't really compete. But I think a lot of eyes turned round from major stars when she arrived, because, of course, they all want to know what the Duchess is going to be wearing. And, of course, you can see a bit of the green-eyed monster from a few of them.
She must have had cold shoulders, though. I think she needed a pashmina or something. It would have been freezing.
Like a shrug. Cold
But Neil, as you say, you know, everyone was wanting to see them, say hello. There's some issue with selfies, because I'd love to get a picture with them, but have the stars been banned from getting a selfie with them?
Well, do you know, I mean, it's the ultimate selfie, isn't it, really? Let's be honest, you know. To be snapped with just either one of them, really, is fantastic. But, yes, even the stars, the biggest Hollywood stars you can imagine, like the likes of Meryl Streep, your very own Nicole Kidman, they've been politely requested not to ask for selfies. This is because some of the people at very high-end in royal office think that it's demeaning and making it more of a celebrity brand rather than... And I quite agree with this. We want them to be slightly aloof. It's something that you aspire to, that you could possibly hope to meet them at one point. But I think just saying, hey, can you get a picture with me? Oh, can we do it again? It's not quite worked out. It's not really going to cut it. And, of course, there's some very good tight security measures around the royal couple to make sure that this doesn't happen, girls.
Absolutely, and I know my management won't let me do any selfies with anyone either.
Makes you too human.
Yeah, that's right.
Makes you too human.
We want to keep my brand up. Yeah. Now, talking of Hollywood royalty and royalty, last time we spoke, you spotted Meghan Markle with Prince Harry, and now you have details about their secret plan to come out as a couple. What's that about, Neil?
Well, it's the biggest thing, isn't it? You know, we've all been there. We're coming up to Valentine's Day. I'm still available, by the way. We're coming up to Valentine's Day. And it's one of those things where, you know, when you're in a new relationship and you're not quite sure when to announce it to everybody. Of course, we know that they're a couple, but there's like this official thing, isn't it? We're exclusive, as they say. Now, my spies tell me that this particular date will be around about May time. It will be the wedding to a gentleman called James Matthews, who's going to be marrying a very famous lady now called Pippa Middleton. And that's when they want to debut as a couple, you see. Very clever move. But I'm also placing the bets on people like, of course, the lovely Princess Charlotte and Prince George having a very active role in that wedding too. So Prince Harry and Meghan might be slightly upstaged, you know.
There's a lot of upstaging going on. Neil, Donald Trump is planning a visit to the UK later in the year. Seems to be going really well. Is he likely to meet the Queen or any of the royals?
I just love that comment, going really well. Of course it's going well, yes. Now, let me tell you, this is what happens. The Queen basically cannot say either way whether she wants to meet the newly elected President Donald Trump. Here's the inside track, though, because you may have read today that the plan now visit, you know, this big visit, may now be moved to the centre of England in Birmingham. What I can tell you, though, is that in order to maybe restore some semblance to it all, the Queen, the royal family, the advisers, etc., are debating about not actually meeting where they would normally meet at Buckingham Palace, but way up in Balmoral, which is at the very top, of course, in Scotland, which would mean it'd be very difficult for protesters, for any problems that, you know, could possibly ensue. But the Queen herself, you know, as I say, doesn't comment on these matters. And the bottom line is it would be very difficult for her now to refuse to meet him. And why, you know, why would she? You know, of course, our Prime Minister has agreed this. So I think the Queen, although very much much her own lady, even at 90 years old, definitely would not want to break that agreement and, of course, royal protocol.
A few nice golf courses in Scotland. Maybe they'll have a bit of a swing together. Yeah. Neil Sean, reporting from the UK, thank you very much.
Pleasure. Take care. See you soon.